Hey everybody, welcome back to another Minecraft episode. Today we're going to be building a really big redstone project, one that's pretty impactful as far as the world goes, and today we're going to be doing it a little bit different. As you guys know, what I usually do when I build redstone is I kind of just show chunks of it, but today I'm actually going to time-lapse the entire thing. I mean, literally every single block that's placed, I'm going to do that just so you guys can see exactly what I did. Yeah, let's not waste any time. Even at time-lapsing, it's still a 30-minute farm, so you know it took me quite a few hours to build. So now you guys might be asking, what are we going to do next? Well, that ties into what I've actually kind of already been doing in between episodes. So if you notice here, we built this, I think, two or three episodes ago, but we only built, I think, these first three layers. Well, I was going to do it on camera, but then I decided it's too boring, and you know what, I'll just do it and then show you guys. I have tripled the amount on the bamboo farm, so I added, I think, these three layers and then these top three layers. So I almost tripled it, right? But this is just bamboo just for, you know, scaffolding and just to have bamboo. But today we're going to be building, and I'm very excited, we're going to be actually building an industrial level bamboo farm that's specifically for smelting and fuel. So long story short, if you guys don't know, bamboo can be used as fuel. It's not very effective, but bamboo is one of the fastest growing plants, I think the fastest growing, and you can produce a lot of it very quickly, basically getting infinite power. So today we're going to be building Silent Whisperer's bamboo design. So I'll explain it, but you guys are going to see it. It's basically just a giant layer of land with bamboo, and then you have a flying machine just kind of going across, and then at the bottom you have hoppers picking it all up. It sounds simple, but it's actually pretty big, and it took me quite a few hours. So another thing that I did in preparation for this unlimited fuel is, obviously, we need a new furnace place, because if you guys remember, this is our old furnace setup, right? We've just got a bunch of chests and a bunch of furnaces, and we've got blocks of coal. This worked amazingly, but I wanted something automated, right? So what I did, and again, this one I actually did do on camera, but then my file got lost or deleted or corrupted. So down here, I started building, this is the framework, and it's probably going to be expanded. The big farm that we're going to build is gonna come down through these hoppers. Then these hoppers are all fueling all of those furnaces down the line. All of these chests are just for stuff, and you can see right here stuff like right now I'm smelting some cactuses. I think I'm gonna smelt some terracotta, some stone, and all that stuff piles in here. So yep, the bamboo comes from the back, the stuff comes in for the front, and all of that rolls all the way down here. And you can see I've already been doing a lot of stone, a lot of food, a bit of glass, some terracottas, rolling in some cactus. So we've got bigger storages, we got the furnace set up, we've expanded a lot of things in our world. Now it's time to build the actual farm itself. Once again, this is Silent Whisperer's design, so it's not like my original design. And you're gonna be watching me build the entire thing brick by brick, exception it's a pretty big building. There's a lot of glass. I'm not going to show every single piece of glass, but all of the redstone, all of the parts, and the main infrastructure, you'll see it all. I can't lie, I could try, but I miss you. Is it just a VR touch? Can't hide it, you find all my triggers. You're in my blood like a drug. Keep playing the message you left on my answer phone. Maybe the sound of your voice made me overdose on you. Push you out, let you in. I can't get through. Crashing down, need you like a medicine.
The sound of your voice made me overdose. is how I treat my soul. But I don't need another sign. Throw me into the fire. Finally I'm the brighter. And I break these chains that I'm locked in. I did this to me. Cause it's worth all the pain when I shed my skin.
We'll be right back. It's a dream raining over me, but deep down it's so lonely. how I wanted this to be. Lost that part of me, yeah. And now I'm doing it all again. Lost control of this heart. Feel it tearing us apart. If we can stop before this ends, I will fix all that I've bent. I won't let you hurt again.
catch me.
Are you ready for the final reveal? I did some last touch-ups. Go ahead and finish the entrance, the back, and I think you saw me do the interior. So let's go ahead, and there it is. So that is the full building. Like I said, all that I did off camera was just this little piece right here, just because I didn't know exactly how to design it, and building things like that on camera isn't the best. But yeah, there's a final project. Let's go ahead and let's get an aerial view just so you guys can kind of see. This is definitely one of the bigger builds in my world, even comparative to like my tower or my castle. It's pretty big. I'll give you one last little angle here. And yeah, the farm is obviously just a farm. The exterior is completely my design. But yeah, let's go through it and let's start off at the top here. So the top layer, I wanted to be able to go inside it because I wanted the glass so I could look down, so I could spectate the machine actually working. So you could see here, it's actually just, I think it's going back at the moment. I think it just went across and it's going back. And then obviously if something ever goes wrong with this I can use a trapdoor to go down and fix it. And it actually does happen quite often where this machine gets stuck. And if that ever happens to you and you build this, just a quick note, all you have to do is just go touch one of the observers, and then it should come back to life and it'll keep roaring along. So that is the top here. The rest of it, you can't go in because it's just, you know, this is basically just all height for the bamboo to grow high, even though it won't ever grow that high. You know, I might as well make it big, because even the tutorial, the guy said, you know, make it 18 high. So you know what? I made it 18 high. So we can take a look at the sides here. You guys kind of already saw the pattern, but even down here, I went ahead and, so we have this entrance here. I went ahead and just kind of put like a little design. Obviously got to flex a little bit, so go ahead and put some diamonds and gold up in there. And I made this little entrance. And then let me show you guys the other side. The other side looks kind of the same, but a little bit different with a different pattern, partly because this one doesn't have to go high. So this one's more of just like a door pattern. And then this is a design with the gold and the diamonds. Now, if we go inside over here, I went ahead and furnished the floor here with the purple. I still got the road going through the entire building. I know it doesn't really match, but I wanted it to kind of stay uniform because I did have the building go, the road coming through here beforehand. So you can see, like, I just kind of like made it look like a solid bridge. Under here, I haven't done anything yet, and obviously all of the stuff comes over here into these, and this goes down into the furnace area. And what I did is I just have hoppers going through here, and it actually connects with the hoppers from the other farm, so they kind of go together, which is kind of cool. And then if we go up here, and it's just coming back, and you can see all of the, there you go. All of the timers are right here, so I can control the timers if need be. From here, I left glass just so I could see the tracks if anything goes wrong or gets destroyed or gets stuck or broken. And here I can also control the timer if I wanted to. I made this little ladder up here, so this is the timer itself. So if I ever need to change the flying machine, I can go up here. I can activate the rails. If I put anything here, it'll activate the rails if ever needed. And then, like I said, I never need to break through this glass just because I have that up there. As far as the farm, that's really about it. I would go in there, but it's really nothing special. It's just a bunch of bamboo. So there is one final look at it right there. And then, like I said, I went ahead and connected it up to these hoppers from this other farm. And now everything goes down to the same place, down to the furnace. Yeah, so it is kind of weird having two of the exact same farms, but you can kind of see this is like my own design. This is a professional's design. I want to say his is any better than mine, except his is lossless, faster, more items, looks nicer, more compact, basically just everything. But hey, I like this one because I built it. That one I also do like very much, but that's just only because it's basically giving me unlimited fuel, which is coming right over here. Alright guys, I know that time lapse was very, very long, so I'm going to end the episode off here. Okay. Guys, thanks for watching. If you did enjoy, make sure to like and comment, as supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.